are making a bit of a noise in the background. And before we let you go, if conditions are good tomorrow, the kind of bowling pitch that the Proteas will be taking the Australians on, compared to Newlands, what would you say?
Well, it's bouncier. There's less seam movement. There was swing today. I'll come out and say it, and I'll stop beating about the bush and sitting on the fence. I actually think that there's a surprise in store. I think that I think Steyn in particular will prosper, and I think that Morné Morkel with his extra bounce could do an excellent job. Vernon Philander loves a little bit of seam movement, doesn't need a big green seaming wicket. So I just think that Australia are not in quite as strong a position as most pessimists are thinking, with South Africa making 266. I think they might get a lead, but I don't think they'll find it easy.
And Monday will hold you to it. Neil Manthorpe, thank you very much for your time this afternoon. Speaking to us live and direct from the Wanderers, where play has been stopped due to bad light on television. I'll be actually just going to stop a moment. And then a very interesting question. Somebody says, who's been misunderstood most? Peter de Villiers or Sepp Blatter? I'm sure you have some answers. Don't forget, rapid fire after news, so give us a call with your questions right now.
The Family Policy Institute, which promotes family values, has demanded the City of Cape Town remove two billboards at the strip club. The billboards from Maverick's Gentlemen's Club on the N1 highway into Cape Town and on Kloofneck depicts a half-dressed woman. The Institute's Errol Naidoo says the image objectifies women.
This billboard sends out a message that women are sexual objects. Those images are disturbing.
The City of Cape Town's Tiny Hatton says they can act against the company because the signs contravene the city's outdoor signage bylaw.
The City of Cape Town's Environmental Resource Management Department has written to the companies to request them to take them down.
Judge Patrick Makubela's registrar has been testifying in the trial of his widow. Sandy Makubela and Vela Mabena are accused of killing the judge in 2009. The man who they suspected of robbing someone in his taxi rank. The police is November slander.
Was later called again and tied up with a rope. He was also stripped from his clothes and marched down to the Nyanga police station.
Economic Development Minister Edwin Patel says the targets contained in the Green Economy Accord are ambitious. The Accord aims to boost both manufacturing and smart green technologies, along with creating 300,000 jobs over the next decade. Patel explains the Accord contains 12 commitments.
There are commitments here by government to regulatory measures.
And to enjoy this more and more, team in studio, ready to field your questions for rapid fire. Jean, we ready to claim victory for yesterday, right?
Yes,
thank you. That's 1-0. And then the day before was a bit of a drop.
Cans are 100% recyclable and sustainable. Visit candoof.sa.com for more.
CWS. The cricket, the big story of the day, but with it.
Dim run to hear the last man out. Bad light, stopping play to thwart any chance of a late Proteas attack on their visitors opening day. That means now that 10:03 tomorrow morning is the official start time. Back home, the Cobras coach, Richard.